Hey guys, what's going on? It's Nock. Welcome along to the stream. Playing some Infinifactory again tonight. And we are going to be tackling Skip Drive Part 2, the final factory. In which, hopefully, fingers crossed, we can actually think about putting this to bed, which would be really nice. So welcome on to stream, guys. Hope you are all well. My chatbot is down for some reason tonight. I don't know why. It says that Twitch is having some OAuth issues. So yeah, there's no commands unfortunately tonight. I'm just going to go back to old school ways of communicating with you guys. So hopefully I'll keep my eye on chat. Everything will be fine. But yeah, we're back here with Skip Drive, and I think I'm going to start fresh. The way we was kind of going about things in the last episode was, it was just really blowing my mind. And I was just miles and miles away. So I'm still not really entirely sure how I properly achieve this. Looking at the pieces we got here, I can kind of see to attach that to that and that to make a top and a bottom, which I'm going to want to do 4 times. Which would give me like those bits. Then I'm pretty sure I can like add some welders. So, okay, I'm gonna start with this. Just like building with Lego. That's right, Lord Manfred. What's going on, buddy? Welcome on to stream. Hope you are well. So, I think what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna rotate this. With a conveyor over here like that. So then we do this. How would we then attach? Let's think. We could do something like this. So all I'm worried about at the minute is just like attaching the top thing. What's going on, Lack? Welcome to the stream, buddy. Yeah, this is part two, and I'm actually starting again tonight. I decided that was possibly the better thing to do. I'm sure we'll have a decision whether or not that is a worthwhile argument or not real soon. Okay, so how far did I get last time? Basically, last time I had built, I got this central core. I was working on the central core, so I tell you what. Let's let me show you, rather than try to explain. So we got all this going last time. So what was happening was, let's run through it. You'll see. Okay. Ignore everything on that side for now. It's literally like the central core. So this was dropping down. The central core was being built and then released. That would then drop onto the top, and that would sit on there. Now, the issue here I was having was the welding, because of various bits and pieces. I would need to push... I think we kind of summarized that I would need to... This kind of rotates in kind of like a weird kind of way that we were trying to do things with suggestions from Iron Smeltery. But this would need to be like extended one more to actually attach this. But we came to the realization that I don't think we can actually weld the bottom bit. So the bottom's kind of... It's almost waste of time at the moment. Because we have to join everything else together to actually get that to stick. And I was just getting like really frustrated. I think I spent like over probably about 3/4 an hour just trying to mess about with this. And I just got so frustrated. And in the end, I was just like, you know what? I wanted to start as a fresh today. As a brand new thing. Try it with a different approach and see if we can actually make a bit more progress. So that's where we are with this. Now, the thing is here, for this to work, I would then need to drop this down. See, where would this end up? That would be the bottom of that. So I'd want to go 1, 2, 3. So I kind of want to come in at this level. So... Is that going to push that across, actually? Yes. Okay, I kind of pushed it across. So, in that case... Could I achieve something like this? I'd need to bring this out further one more for this to work. So we bring this out one more. And so this. Okay, so that would then come across to here, and then I would have welders here and here, effectively. But then, because of not having the delay, that would need to come further across here. But then by the time that gets across, that's already left. Yeah, I think we're going to have to use some form of buffer. I think it's going to need more than a one unit buffer though, isn't it? I kind of feel maybe... I would want this here, for instance. But then... conveyors need to go here. Man, can't even get the conveyors. No, I would want to be here. So then I would want... also, putting them up there is messing with the rotation. Really? Really? Oh man, the... the speed of this is just crazy. So we're going to need to pull this one out a little bit further. See, that would then come across and get welded. Block would need to be here. Okay, so that kind of works. Okay. Come out one, two. Okay. Is it here? No, it wants to come down another one. And we'll censor it here. Okay. Can I get a conduit under here, please? Thank you. Okay, so move this across one more. Excellent. Okay. Excellent, until they start getting out of sync. So we combat that with where we're going to want the sensor. Here, I guess, would be fine. Oh no, it wants to be another one up, because this is the bottom, isn't it? So my sensor wants to be here. No, sensor wants to be on the other side. It's the same height, just the other side. Like so. Because then it will only release once it's in position. Alright, so it's the... So it's the top that's getting out of sync. What if I got rid of the conveyor? Alright, so it's not such a good idea. However... Okay. Okay. This may be a bit elaborate, but okay, and then I'm going to have one sensor say here. Another sensor here. Okay, so that one will release that one. This one to release this one. So the idea is the block at the top will control actually, that's going to need to be a cross one, isn't it? So what will happen is the block will get to here. This isn't working how I'd anticipated. Double sensor will increase the activation time. Yeah, I'm starting to think this isn't going to work. Which is a shame. Alright, let's take all this out again. Alright, so my plans for a delayed activation or some sort of like patterned thing there are in vain. So do I not just need to, like, I don't think it will. Doesn't rotate it. I think the rotator takes too much time to rotate, but I mean, in effect, the rotator takes one extra block of movement, right? So it delays the block by one. Yeah. Okay. So, if I delay that going across by one, effectively, will these stay in sync? Yes. Okay. So that will get them back into sync. Okay. Do you know what? I don't know that there was a problem before. I think what's happening is this. I think that's building up and it was stopping it from rotating. I think that's what the issue was, but this seems to work better. Okay, well, I'm happy with the way that's working now. I just wonder if it was like that part of the central core itself that was actually stopping it from working. All right, so next up, I need to get four of these and then split them. Okay, so once it reaches here, I need to do something. So, let's do something along the lines of this. Alright, so does this work? It sure does. Okay, so... two of these need rotation. That's gonna work though, because the side, I'm gonna have to do that instead. Okay, but actually, what I need to do instead actually, there's only one that needs to stay. I need to rotate three of them. There are three different rotations here, aren't there? So... going to want to stagger these. Something like that. Okay. Actually happened with that rotation in the second one. Rotates. Oh, but then it's not got enough room to rotate a second time. Okay. I believe that's what happened anyway. Well, maybe I do this instead. Alright, Lack, thanks for stopping by, buddy. Thanks for coming by and saying hi. Okay. So I have that, and I have that, and I just need one more rotation. We which we can achieve here, I hope. So, we do this instead. Still not enough. Still not enough room. Is it? Do we put it somewhere like here? All right, it's not getting. Thanks for the lurk, Hocus. Appreciate it, buddy. How you doing tonight? Okay, so I think that's not working because of this. Thank you. why isn't that rotating a second time?
Right, you know what? Let's do something. Like this instead.
So that creates everything we need, and it rotates it into the correct orientation. Okay, so what's going to be next? Alright, so I don't need to go as far out. I can get away with something like this. So, so let's plan this out. That should give me 4. Oh. Okay, that wasn't taking up as much room as I anticipated. Gonna want to move this across to here. 1, 2, 3, 4. Let's take off 3 from the end. Just 3, right? It's got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Really? Taking up 9 blocks? So it's 3. I guess it's 3. 3 and then every 2. So 1, 2, 3. Magic conduit. Gonna go down to a sensor on here. And then our conveyors are gonna be here, 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 and here. Then we're going to be taking them over something like this. Maybe instead I'm going to target middle blocks. Okay, so then that pushes these down here. Something like this. So what should happen is the middle two will drop down, but then they will separate off once they've dropped down. We shouldn't get any overlapping.
Okay. Excellent.
Okay, so once we have these on the shelf, what are we going to want to do next? I think the next smart move would be to... put the bottom on. So I put the bottom on. Okay. So, let's have a top-down sensor here. So... we're gonna have something like this. Okay, let's move it. And top down sensor here. Pusher. then I'm going to want... Pusher can't go there. Pusher can go here. One, two, three. Okay, so that's going to now separate them off, right? Okay. So we can clear this. And... just pop a conveyor on the end there so I can see whereabouts I need to drop it. We will ping this one across. Okay, then it should come to a final resting place of there. Check that again. Needs to come across a little bit more. Okay. So these two, these middle two. I've just thought of a way to potentially simplify. Alright. Here's what I'm going to do. I am binning off solution one. Okay, so the way to simplify is this isn't going to do any rotation. No rotation will be undertaken here. Okay, instead, what's going to happen is... remember how this falls down. So it's all going to be that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put one bit on at a time and rotate, rotate, rotate. Which should make things simpler. I hope. So in order for that to work, actually needs to drop on here, won't it? So, so I just need a way to then block the rotation here. Okay. So, once I... something like that. So, Yeah, I'm good, thanks, buddy. How you doing? And don't worry about not hanging around, buddy. Not a problem at all. Not a problem at all. It's going to drop on there, so when what? Once that drops, I can have a sensor here as far as that goes. So then I just need a sensor here. The role of this sensor will be to release that from there, right? Let's see. Okay. That works. It works. So, we need to come over here. That's not going to work, is it? It's going to need to go here. Alright, something didn't quite work right there. It's gonna be a tweak. Maybe put a counter of three there instead? I also see another problem here now, as well. I'm not going to clear this. This whole section, I'm not going to clear. So, thank you. Okay. Just need to make sure I've got enough. Hold on, needs to be 1, 2, 3.
It's not gonna work there, is it?
Base one. Base. But the problem with that is how do I avoid everything else that's going on? I mean, I suppose I just go. Same as what's going on here. Maybe. Oh, you just be trolling now, game. Game be trolling. Hayden. Hey, look at that. All right, we did a thing and stuff. Okay, so. We get to here. One. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. That's not welded in the right place. Damn. Oh, you turd. There we go. Okay. Just get this moving. Okay. So then that goes to... She wants to come out here, doesn't it? So that's going to go there and there. Which means this one... Two. It's going to drop to there. With 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, so let's just run this through a minute. So I can have a vertical sensor here. Which will then release this one. To there. Then we're going to have this on here. Okay, so I can go up and over again. Yeah, I need to go up and over again. Problem is now, I have to try and find a different way for this sensor. three, four, five. Maybe a counter of five. One, two, three. Yeah, you see, that's not going to work. We're going to need to reconfigure this. Just trying to think. What if I put the counter here? It's going to be over. I'll run through that again. Just want to see when this actually activates. That's actually perfect. Okay, so then Okay. So then this one. Goes to here. Okay. And then we have welders on a piston. That's a counter of three. Okay. So then okay. Okay, something went wrong there. I thought this was meant to be like a
an easier way of doing things. It's the counter. It works for three for a start, but then as it moves across, it counts an extra time, doesn't it? Counter there. What's it at now? That's problematic. Okay. Let's go for something completely different. Again. So what I want to try and do this time is
Let's bring everything down to one level, rather than dropping things in from the top. Let's see if we have more success playing on a single level. Let's get rid of all of this stuff here. Okay. So, okay. Let's move everything across. Like this. Let's move it some more, it seems. Okay, so maybe I do something like this. Okay, maybe I need to Why is it so difficult? I don't know. Why is it so difficult just to move? It's insane. Moving. Why does it stop moving them? Could be the reason. Do you know what? At this point, I pretty much give up tonight. All I'm trying to do is simplify. Simplify. So the next best way to simplify is go back to what we had before. Thank you. Okay. This is some progress, at least. I need to move them far enough away so that the ledge, like the cross section, doesn't get caught like that. All right. So progress is being made. So the counter here could be 4. Actually, no, the counter wants to be 4. With pusher. And then we'll secure that on here like this. Let's get rid of them for now. Let's work on one thing at a time. Oh, for Christ's sake. Turn these round. Okay. So it hits that. And then... it then releases that. All right, so I'm gonna leave it there. But I think this is a lot cleaner and a lot better way to do this. So we're all at one level so that we're not dropping things in and getting like reduced space and whatnot. So yeah, okay, so this is solution three, right? Yes, okay. So I'm gonna clear the other two solutions because I'm not happy with the way these are working. They're just too complicated. Look at all that. To do three of those when I've just literally reduced it to that. Alright, so as far as Infinifactory goes, we will be back tomorrow night. I am putting off Black Hole and possibly Final Fantasy VII because I just really want to get this done. I feel like I've made some good progress tonight. So once we've got like the edges attached, the next thing to then do will be to join the, create the center column with a thing on top, which that's got a difficult weld, so we'll have to really think about that. We then drop that into position and weld one of the top bits to one of the uprights. We put things on the side and then we should be done. Should be done. But there's still quite a lot of work. But for everybody on YouTube, that is going to be the end today of Infinifactory. Thank you very much for watching. As always, I've been Nock. You've been awesome. See ya.